Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of all ages. Welcome to this edition of the RV Bandwagon. Today, here I am in the coach, in the driver's seat, preparing to launch. I'm in launch mode. And we have everything pretty much ready to go back there. The engine's running. Coast is clear. Headed to Salem to finish up that paint job. This is the second trek I've made in the trek. And so hopefully this will be the last one until we start the next phase over there. But it's looking pretty good, and I'm going to keep you guys up to date and show you what's going on. So let's take a road trip to Salem. Here we go. All right, guys, out on the highway, headed up to I-5 and out to Salem. Here we go. Check this out. We've got UFOs right here. Check this out. Dun dun dun. Strange but true. Well, guys, I'm almost to Salem right now, and just reflecting on some things while I'm driving down the road, which you often do, I think, when you're driving your motorhome. This thing is kind of like driving my living room, except for the TV's making a little bit of rattly sound in here. I don't have enough foam up there. That's all right. But the rest sounds pretty good back there. Everything's hanging in there, no problems. But, you know, the cool thing is, I'm able to do this. I'm actually cruising down the road right now in my motorhome that I fixed up and made what I wanted it to be. And now my intention was to take the motorhome out and make money with it and, you know, paint windows and paint walls and do gigs and that kind of thing. And man, I've been doing it. You know, it's kind of cool to think back and go, man, wouldn't it be cool if I could do something like have a motorhome and cruise around and paint cool places and make videos? And now look at me, you know, I'm doing it. Whether good, bad, or indifferent, I'm still doing it. And, you know, today is, Wednesday, I think. It is Wednesday today. And it's Wednesday, and I'm driving my motorhome, and it's a beautiful day, and I'm headed to Salem, where I'm going to be painting some walls that I've been working on for the last couple weeks, off and on. And you know what? That's freaking awesome. And then after this, I have another location to go to and paint as well. So I'm just thinking about that. I think it's pretty freaking cool, and there you go. Live the dreams that you guys have going through your heads. There's no sense in waiting till tomorrow to get those dreams off the ground, because often if you wait, the wait just keeps continuing and things get in your path and you get distracted. All I can say is go for it, guys. You can do the same thing, man. Get out on the road, do what you want to do. If it's RVing, if it's building your own house, if it's having a family, you know what? Just do it. Life's short. Live it, guys. All right, guys, it's a nice evening out. Been painting all day, painted all day yesterday, and this is my little campsite setup. I've got my folding producer's chair right here, and it's a little bit breezy. I call this the breezeway. Nice soothing breeze. I got my safari carpet out here for my titsies, and so hang out and chilling for the evening. I'm going to be back on it tomorrow morning for 3 or 4 hours, and then I'm out of here back to Eugene, where I have to do karaoke tomorrow night and Saturday night. So it's been a busy week and getting a lot done. I'm going to show you what's going on right now. Let's check it out. Guys, as you can see, it's not so empty anymore. We've got carpet in here. I've got almost all the walls painted. Got some games going on in here right now. It's looking pretty good. They're supposed to be opening maybe next week if they can get the permit for cutting this door right here. There's a door that goes between the pizza place and here. And that's why that's not quite painted there. But they're supposed to be doing that this next week, and I'll touch up whatever they need me to touch up. I've got this back section, which I'll be doing next week. It's going to be a castle, and I'm going to do it as a tutorial for Halloween. So if you guys are interested in building a castle or having dungeon scenes, this area over here that's all white, I'm going to be doing like a gothic type castle. So with, you know, wizards and that kind of thing. Over here, tomorrow morning, I'll put up a couple superheroes representing the male and female bathrooms. We've got a Spider-Man going up there, and then restrooms across the top. And really, so that's not a lot comparatively to what I've done. We've got the Blacklight Arcade in here, but they're finishing putting in the machines, and that'll kind of tell us where we can paint. I've got maybe 4 or 5 different characters to paint in there, so not a lot in there. I'm really almost done with this particular job. However, I'm going to be doing some stuff up on the ceiling to represent asteroids and space scenes and Star Wars vehicles up above. So I've got a couple more weeks of work here. They've got me doing some other stuff over in the pizza place. It starts way over there and continues all the way around and continues all the way over here. And these are big pieces. These are giant size. I mean, I'm small compared to these giant creatures I've painted. So very, very large and in charge. I like this Darth Vader. He looks really good. I don't know if you can see him. He's kind of dark up there, but he's Darth Vader. He's supposed to be. He's got his lightsaber there. And of course, Yoda. We might put in a few more characters down the road, but for right now, we're staying within their budget and trying to keep things on par as far as time goes. And that's about it. Hope you enjoy my Star Wars painting, Jurassic Park painting, and soon to be gothic dragons and superheroes. There you guys go, the inside of the new game room there, and pretty proud of that. It's taken me a very short time to do such a big job, but really this is doing it, man, living the dream right here. As I said, I wanted to take the rig out, and I wanted to do painting, and I wanted it to pay me and put gas in the rig and allow me to do things. This is the baby steps of it. And I'm going to be traveling actually south on one of my next upcoming trips to do the same kind of thing, taking the rig out for a paint run. And I'm going to take you guys along with me. So it's really, this whole paint run thing has started a little differently than I was thinking it might. But it has definitely started, and it's quite busy. And I might have a helper sooner or later. I almost did on this one, however, this got postponed a little bit, and so I had to come out and kind of take care of business on my own. But maybe in the upcoming future I'll have a helper to make my vlogs more interesting, more powerful, and get my jobs done quicker, and that'd be better. and the rig is holding up awesome. I just cannot say enough on how happy I am with how it's been driving and how it's been taking care of me, and how well it's done as far as gas mileage, all that kind of stuff. Really, if you're making money like I am, it's a drop in the bucket to drive this thing. And I don't mind driving it as far as size. I get in and out of every place that I've tried, even AMPM Mini Mart. Yep, took this thing right in there, no problem. It is the best rig I've ever had as far as a motorhome type unit goes. And it's for so many reasons, I can't even count them anymore. This is proof that you guys can get a rig and go out and make money by using your rig. And all you got to do is just do it. Find something that works, get out there, hustle a bit, and pretty soon you'll be doing it more than you even can imagine. And you know one thing? If I didn't stop working over there at the hotel, this wouldn't be possible. I wouldn't be here right now. I wouldn't be able to do my own thing and create my own artwork and get my own jobs and make more money if I didn't say, you know what, I need to do something different. And as long as I keep in motion, the wheels will keep turning in motion. So here I am, I'm in motion, watch me roll. Here we go, let's roll.